Peptidoglycan is the major component of the cell wall of the bacteria. In case of gram-positive bacteria, the peptidoglycan layer is thick, but in case of gram-negative bacteria, the peptidoglycan layer is thin. But the component peptidoglycan is very much essential for forming of a bacterial cell wall. Hello friends, welcome to Biology Concerned. I am Animesh, and in this video I am going to discuss about the formation or biosynthesis of peptidoglycan, how peptidoglycan layer is formed, and it actually helps to form the bacterial cell wall. So let's jump into the topic. First thing, the peptidoglycan layer is basically composed of NAG and NAM. So NAG stands for N-acetyl glucosamine and NAM stands for N-acetyl muriatic acid. So in case of gram-negative bacteria, the peptidoglycan layer is thin, and the component of the gram-negative bacteria is along with NAG and NAM. So the NAM component, so this is basically NAM and this is basically NAG. So NAM consists of alanine, glutamate, DPA, mesodiamino-pimetic acid and alanine. Okay, so four amino acids are present in case of gram-negative bacteria cell wall. But in case of gram-positive bacteria, here is alanine, lysine, alanine and alanine. Those five components are present. So in case of gram-positive bacteria, five amino acids are present, and in case of gram-negative bacteria, only four amino acids are present. So this is the basic major difference between gram-positive and gram-negative cell wall. So how peptidoglycan is synthesized in a bacteria? So here this is a diagram of how a peptidoglycan layer is formed. The each and every component to the formation of peptidoglycan is certainly formed in the cytoplasm of any bacteria, and after that a particularly transporter enzyme that is known as bactoprenol. So this bactoprenol helps those individual components of the peptidoglycan, that is NAG and NAM, to get outside of the cell membrane and ultimately form the peptidoglycan layer. So in this case, here the formation of the peptidoglycan layer as follows. So first, fructose 6-phosphate is converted to UDP, N-acetyl glucosamine. Okay, so fructose 6-phosphate first converted into UDP, N-acetyl glucosamine. Here UTP comes and one inorganic phosphate is released. So UDP now binds with fructose 6-phosphate and it ultimately forms UDP, N-acetyl glucosamine. After that, phosphoenol pyruvate and NADPH, those along with MUR-A and MUR-B enzyme, they actually transforms those UDP N-acetyl glucosamine to UDP N-acetyl muriatic acid. So UDP N-acetyl muriatic acid. After that, alanine comes and MUR-C enzyme attaches this alanine molecule or alanine amino acid with this particularly UDP N-acetyl muriatic acid. So alanine now attached with UDP N-acetyl muriatic acid. After that, glutamine comes and glutamine is attached with alanine, and after that lysine attached with glutamine, and next alanine and alanine comes, and those two amino acids are getting joined together with this particularly lysine residue of this particular chain, and this ultimately forms UDP N-acetyl muriatic acid, alanine, glutamine, lysine, alanine and alanine, these five residues. So this is basic component of gram-positive cell wall. After that, this particular component UDP N-acetyl muriatic acid and those five amino acids is converted into lipid 1. So this is now called as lipid 1. So this lipid 1 is now converted with the help of MUR-G enzyme to lipid 2. Okay, so when the lipid 1 is converted into lipid 2, then N-acetyl glucosamine is added with this particularly N-acetyl muriatic acid component along with these five amino acids. So after that, tRNA glycine comes, and tRNA glycine is basically attached with this particularly glutamine amino acid. Okay, and then again tRNA glycines comes, and those tRNA glycines attached with this tRNA glycine molecule, and these amino acids are growing longer and longer and ultimately these two lipid two is now formed a five residue long chain, and this is the complete structure of a single peptidoglycan layer. Okay, so this is now called as lipid 2 glycine 5. So why it is glycine 5? Because there is five glycine residues is present. Now bactoprenol comes into play. So bactoprenol helps to transport these particular residue from cytosol to outside of the surface. Whenever this particular residue or particular single unit attached with undecaprenyl diphosphate, so these black molecules are undecaprenyl diphosphate. Whenever undecaprenyl diphosphate is attached with this particular subunits of NAG and NAM, so this is NAG and this is NAM, along with several amino acids are attached with there. So then bactoprenol comes into play, and this bactoprenol helps to transport these individual subunits from the cytosol to outside of the bacteria. And whenever it comes outside of the bacteria, these subunits converse, these subunits are joined with each other and formed a bacterial peptidoglycan layer. So here, in here, PBP, that is the penicillin binding protein. So penicillin binding protein. So penicillin binding protein plays a major role. So in the next slide, I will discuss about the function of penicillin binding protein or transpeptides. So basically, the synthesis of gram-positive cell wall. So here, whenever lipid 2, so in previous slide you observe that lipid 2 comes from the cytoplasm or cytosol to the outside of the bacteria. Okay, so whenever this lipid 2 molecule comes outside of the bacteria, then PBP comes into play, that is the penicillin binding protein also. And this here an enzyme acts as a major role, that is, they are known as transpeptides. So what is transpeptides does? Transpeptides cleaves alanine. So basically D-alanine, the last molecule of D-alanine is getting separated from one of the layer of this NAG and NAM. So in the case here, the lower layer, so this is the lower layer, or this is the contrast with the cytoplasm. So from lower layer, this NAM, the D-alanine getting separated from this NAM component, and ultimately this D-alanine binds with this particular lysine residue. Okay, so lysine and alanine forms a bond together, and this is the 3-4 bonding. Okay, so as you observe here, 1, 2, 3, 4, this is the 4 number of residue, that is the 4 number amino acid, and this is the 3 number amino acid. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, so 3 and 4 linkage is present here, observed in here. So lysine bonds with alanine, so lysine is 3 number amino acid from the upper side, and alanine is the 4 number amino acid from the lower side. So basically 3-4 linkage is observed in here. So whenever this 3-4 linkage is occurred, then the teichoic acid comes into play. This teichoic acid actually binds with this particular NAGNAM component, and ultimately it helds together these peptidoglycan layer. So this is one peptidoglycan layer and this is the another peptidoglycan layer. So whenever these two peptidoglycan layer are comes close together, then the teichoic acid holds that two particular peptidoglycan together, and it ultimately forms a thicker peptidoglycan layer. So here transpeptidase, here is the function of the transpeptidase. So whenever, so this is a gram negative cell wall, okay, so this is a gram negative cell wall because diamino pimelic acid is present here, or meso diamino pimelic acid is present in here. So in this case of gram negative bacteria, only meso diamino pimelic acid is observed, but in this case of gram positive bacteria, there is no the meso diamino pimelic acid present. So in this case, transpeptidase cleaves this particularly alanine from the lower surface of the NAM. So this is NAM and this is NAG, and this is also NAM, N-acetyl muriatic acid, and this is N-acetyl glucosamine. So basically what does is this transpeptidase does, this transpeptidase cleaves the particular D-alanine residue what is present the NAM molecule or attached with the NAM molecule along with the cytoplasm. So from the lower surface of that particular NAGNAM components, D-alanine is cleaved off. So D-alanine is cleaved off. Now this 3-4, so this is the 4 and this is the 3. So now 3-4 linking is observed in here. Those 3-4 linking is basically forming the whole peptidoglycan layer. So finally this NAG and NAM, so this cross linking present in each and every NAM together, and these NAM component cross linking is ultimately grow thicker and thicker. So this is one layer, this is second layer, this is third layer, this is fourth layer, and this is fifth layer. So all five layer combines together by lipoic acid and teichoic acid. So teichoic acid plays a crucial role to hold these all layers together, and it ultimately forms a thicker layer of peptidoglycan, and it forms a peptidoglycan layer which is the essential for bacterial cell wall synthesis. So this peptidoglycan is really essential for the forming of cell wall of any bacteria. Hope you like this video. If you like the video, please hit the like button. Don't forget to subscribe, and thanks for watching.